Hey hackers, welcome back, and you are watching Millennial Hacks. Those who are new to the channel, this is all about how to save money and live life to the fullest, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people would want to do that. So thanks for tuning in for today. Now, this topic of this week was going to be about the Chase Freedom Card. Not the unlimited, the Freedom Card. So the Freedom Card is actually one of the first cards that I ever got from Chase as a credit card. And the main reason why I got it was because I already had a bank account set up with them, so I just wanted an easier way of when I do purchases on a credit card, I'm able to just, you know, pay it off right away automatically through my bank. So that's the reason why I got it, and I didn't have really good credit back then, so I actually got approved for this card with at least a 670, I believe. I had a 670 and I got approved right away. So no, it was really cool and it was really easy. I went through an online process and didn't really have to take that much effort. It got approved in like as soon as I pressed the enter button when I entered all my information. But other than that, I want to talk about the first step of this is the Freedom 5% categories. So having these 5% categories are a big major key, especially when with Chase, you can couple your points together, your ultimate rewards, and you can turn them into ultimate rewards points when you have, you know, your Sapphire Preferred or Sapphire Reserve card, which is really beneficial. Now, I only use this card for 5% categories. You know, anything else I won't use it for. So for example, last year around September, I went over to San Francisco for a visit, and when I was there, I was able to use the 5% categories in restaurants. And everyone knows, when you go out to eat, you go out to eat. Like if you're traveling, you're gonna go out to eat regardless, so it's good to just have the 5%. And let me tell you something, I got so many points from just going out to eat with that 5% that I was so good within that month of September. It was awesome, and that was the last month for me to use the 5% with restaurants. So Chase, if you're looking at this video, make sure please bring back that 5% on restaurants. It was very helpful and beneficial. I'm pretty sure it was to a lot of people. That's just a little input there, but you know, it was really good. I got so many points from that, and was able just to save it and use it for travel when I transferred over to my Chase Sapphire Preferred card. Honestly, there's a lot of other categories. There's gas stations, there's supermarkets, you know, using Apple Pay and stuff like that. Those are also really good. So honestly, this is a really, really good card. I want to get into the sign-up bonus for what I got for it. So the sign-up bonus for me was $150 after you spend $500 and within 3 months. This was super easy to get. Most cards just do $1,000 and you get $150 back, but the fact that I had to only spend $500, it was perfect, because around that time I was graduating college and I was just like, you know, let me just apply for this card. And then I had to like spend so much money when I got out of college, as all college students do, with bills and everything, and I was able to just meet that requirement within, you know, 4 weeks basically. So that was pretty good, and I got the $150 back with cash back. And yeah, that's from my story with the bonus. So that bonus is still on as far as today, so if you want to, you guys want to check that out, definitely go ahead and check it out. I'll probably leave like a referral link down at the bottom if you want to check it out through that one. That's also cool too. It will be in the description down below. And also, I also want to talk about the card where it references to the annual fee. So this card is a no annual fee card. Really awesome. You don't have to pay no annual fee throughout any years, whatever. You can just keep the card in your wallet. Still use it on the 5%. Like I said, I only use it when it's on the categories. I don't use it for anything else because you only get 1% back. And I have other cards that give me a better deal than that. And now that Chase has Chase offers inside, you don't even need to get another card. Like, you can use Chase offers and with this credit card, and you can just save up so much points and, you know, get cash back with everything. So honestly, it's a really good cash back card. I say this card is at a level 4 because, you know, you still have to have a little bit of credit history to get this card. And it's not a level 5 because you're not, it's not like a secured card. Secured cards are more like level 5 because you have to put your own money inside to actually spend it. So you're not really borrowing the bank's money. You're kind of just borrowing your money. So, you know, that's really good. People who are coming out of school, definitely recommend this for you. It's a relatively low sign-up bonus, low APR within like the first couple months when you get it. And that's the deal I had when I first got it. And honestly, it's just been a really good card. So with that being said, I want to know, how do you like this card so far, and what you get the Chase Freedom card, what's your recommendation on it? Other cards that do carry the 5% categories are the Discover cards, which are actually really popular as well. And I believe those cards are no foreign transaction fee. So you do have a foreign transaction fee with the Chase cards that don't take this out of the United States. And if you do plan on taking out the United States, just prepare to get charged when you come back. That's about it for now. Honestly, everyone, thank you for watching. And definitely tune in. I'm going to go over 2019, the categories for quarter one of 2019 of the Chase Freedom card. So hopefully I'll leave that little link in the description up above. But, you know, so just click on that. And then also subscribe to this channel if you found this information helpful. And then leave a like. Thank you, guys.